Excellency, you have the floor.
Thank you very much, Your Excellency. Excellencies, ladies and gentlemen, the COVID-19 pandemic has deeply imprinted lives across the globe, but its greatest weight falls on the poor and the new poor because they carry multiple burdens already. 500 million individuals risk being pushed into multidimensional poverty alone, on top of the 1.3 billion that are already multidimensionally poor. While the impact on the world economy has been massive, the downturn has been more pronounced in low-income countries. It is in these settings that fragilities of food, health, and social protection systems have been deeply exposed and inequities have been more intensely exacerbated. The pandemic's socio-economic consequences have undermined people's nutrition worldwide, but more acutely in poorer countries. Livelihoods have been decimated all over the world at an unprecedented scale, especially for those in the informal economy, a majority of whom live in the developing world. During this time of extreme uncertainty and crisis, countries, including my own, invoked warlike mechanisms. When the COVID-19 lockdowns came into effect, our country was at the brink of a humanitarian catastrophe and civil unrest. 160 million people in Pakistan subsist on wages which come from the informal economy, their livelihoods decimated overnight with the lockdowns. As a response, our government allocated resources for cash grants to support 100 million families. SR's cash was delivered end-to-end digitally, and in terms of the percentage of population covered, it was the third largest program globally, following the US and Japan. In terms of speed, its delivery has been rated the fastest globally. The legacy of this program called SR's, which is the Urdu word, our local language word meaning compassion, its legacy is not simply short-term relief. Built into its design are longer-term goals to strengthen overall safety nets and increase social and financial inclusion, both of which will bring lasting benefits and will help the adoption of the 2030 agenda as the country builds back better. The know-how gained in designing and implementing this program in a context of complexity and uncertainty with speed leads us to believe that good data, delivery systems, and a commitment to integrity, transparency, and accountability are crucial to address the long-standing fault lines that have plagued public sector delivery. These attributes are cross-cutting for social protection, for universal health coverage, and basic essential services, and they need to factor in strongly in efforts by all countries to build back better and deliver on SDGs more broadly. As a country, we have also committed to protecting human capital from the negative coping strategies that are inevitable as a result of the pandemic. We placed food security and nutrition at the heart of social protection objectives. Despite the disruption ushered in by COVID, we are on track to upskill a new nationwide health and nutrition conditional cash transfer program. And during this time, we also upscaled our education conditional cash transfer program from 50 to all of the 154 districts of the country and expanded it across the life cycle. Our government has taken measures to signal the importance of the girl child under the 50 plus pro-women and girls SRs policy. Girls get a higher stipend amount in both the conditional cash transfers. To hedge against food price inflation, which is a worldwide phenomenon in the wake of the pandemic, a policy shift is underway towards targeting of commodity subsidies to benefit the vulnerable. And even in the midst of the pandemic, we fast-tracked work to complete the digital social registry. Given its significance in relation to the upscaling of social protection, we are aggressively pursuing. Excellencies, ladies and gentlemen, each country has its own way of addressing welfare and social protection, but the essential building blocks are the same. It is quite clear that an opportunity is within reach to leverage the crisis as a platform for radical change in the way the state conceives and provides social protection. The pandemic has unearthed an opportunity to recast the role of the welfare state, to expand and deepen it, but also to make it shock responsive and resilient. The facts Excellencies, ladies and gentlemen, are very clear. The social resilience and the economic inclusion of tomorrow. Investing in social protection is both a response to current need as well as preparedness for an insurance against future crises. This is not wishful thinking, but solid public policy rooted in robust empirical evidence. The spread of the pandemic shed light on our interconnectedness. A risk in one country can quickly expose others. Similarly, the crisis has also really revealed the need for interconnected solutions. We clearly have an opportunity to create a acceleration towards the goals of social protection, universal health coverage, and universal essential basic services is now possible by using new data and technologies and by leveraging partnerships, which is what Goal 17 is about. And as a corollary, we believe the jobs and conditions that would be created could open up a wider horizon of human development and well-being on a shared planet. I thank you.